So, your uncle. What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, Detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to keep him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Well, here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first.
Abandoned.
It can't be. There has to be someone around.
Wait here. I'll go around back. Dark in here. I can't see anything. I need the key. Now, what do we got here?
Nah, I'm not getting in there. Big tree to fit inside a conservatory. If I do.
Every day you're...
What was that?
Please do not touch the boiler.
That doesn't look safe.
I need the key. I need the key. It's wedged shut. Looks important.
Sunday, June.
I need the key.
Thanks.
What are you doing? Who are you?
Whoa, pardon me, excuse me. My name is Edward Carnby, private investigator. I hope you don't mind we let ourselves inside.
I do mind. This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. It's urgent, and no one was answering the door.
We can't hear you knocking anymore. None of us can.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right? She has that Hartwood gloom, doesn't she?
That's right. I'm Emily Hartwood. I just came to make sure my uncle is all right.
Well, he is unavailable right now. You will have to come back another day.
Unavailable? How? Is he sleeping? We can wait.
He's lost.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Who's your man again, Miss Hartwood?
My name's Edward Carnby, private investigator.
Splendid.
Enough, all of you. Get back to your rooms. McCarthy, keep your eyes on the child. And you two, please leave immediately.
Look, we're not here to cause any trouble. Just let us see the old man, satisfy the curiosity of my client here, and we'll be off.
Jeremy has gone missing. There's no need to worry, but it might be some time before he turns up. The whole staff is looking for him.
What? He ran off?
I don't have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
All right, in that case, we'll just wait in his room. You don't mind, do you? It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent. Thank you, madam.
Let's look around, see if we can dig up any clues.
Every night the dark man stands opaque at the
Hey, you know anything about this? Looks like some sort of talisman.
No, I don't. Oh, help me out here, will you?
Now, would it kill the guy to throw some of this stuff out? I'd be crazy too if I had this much junk lying around.